A blue day for Boeing as investors are reacting to a Wall Street Journal report that says 737 MAX jets could stay grounded until early next year. American Airlines has extended its flight cancellations for the plane for the fifth time. November now is the likely date. The Guardian is reporting that a 737 MAX model name has been changed on a plane. A Ryanair to be delivered to... a 737 to be delivered to Ryanair is described as the 737-8200. Boeing shares are off today, and they're off the lows of the session, but, of course, Boeing always pulls down the Dow with it. CNN's Tom Foreman joins me. Two issues to talk about here, Tom. Let's, first of all, do this report that... until next year. I mean, when I hear, we're already July, when I hear somebody say next year, I'm almost tempted to say, well, what made you think it would be anything but?
Well, yeah, really, when you think about this, look, a couple of months ago, the Boeing CEO was being interviewed, and he said, I'm sure that for everything else that's going on, we'll be back before the end of the year. And at the time, that seemed like a long way off, but now, day after day after day, we get more and more delays. And you know what happened here, Richard? What happened here is they had this catastrophic problem with the MCAS system. No question about that. But what's been killing them ever since is they have had one delay after another. It seems to have opened the box for looking at everything about this airplane, why it was approved, how it was approved, all the other systems involved. Can you fix it with software, or do you need hardware fixes? All of which pushes the delay further and further and further. And yeah, when you've had two massive fatality crashes, you need a lot of scrutiny. But could it get any worse for Boeing right now, Richard? I don't know when it comes to this airplane.
I suppose arguably, Tom, if it is transpired that there has to be some fundamental redesign of either infrastructure or airframe to account for it, then you'd be talking about years. But we're some way off. We're not even on that card yet, I don't think, are we?
No, we're not there yet. And of course, Boeing doesn't want to get to that point because you're right. That would be, yes, in a sense, in a business sense, catastrophic. So they're not there yet. But all of their holding maneuvers have not really been paying off, have they?
What about this story that The Guardian has the pictures of the plane, the Ryanair? I think it's called the 737-8200. Now, it's noticeable that when IAG bought its planes, 200 of them at the Paris Air Show, they didn't use the word MAX at all. They called them the 737-8s and the 737-9s. Do you think MAX is not long for this world in terms of the name?
I think it's gone. It's not gone yet, and Boeing keeps saying they're not looking for a new name, but they could just start ignoring that name and acting like that name doesn't exist and allowing carriers who buy the plane to call them what they wish with a series of numbers like that. It's hard to imagine at this point in time that any airline out there is eager to say we're flying a 737 MAX. And it's hard to see that in the near future. So, yeah, I think the idea that somehow that gets changed is very real. Right now, again, Boeing says they're not searching to do that. But this is true. For this plane to get back in the air, not only does it have to survive all of these tests, not only does it have to get past this enormous scrutiny, not just here in the U.S., but from the international market, but once again, we come to that question of faith. Somehow faith has to be restored, and it's hard to see how you get there with the name MAX hovering over it.